read, I think, at the first annual. Set me going. So it's two news item poems. One is found, one is found and added to. This is Testimony from New Orleans by a woman called Annette Addison. It was at the tribunal on war crimes of neglect. She says, I experienced the neglect of the ones that were supposed to be there for us. They was there, but they did not assist us. Example is, I asked the firemen, do they have any water? They only had enough for themselves. I kept passing out. My son in Orleans Parish Prison, he was due to get out that day. They took prisoners and didn't let nobody know where they put them. If my son didn't know how to swim, he would be dead. They put him on the bridge for so many hours. Wet clothes, black water, fungus on both legs and arms. $2,500 to be bonded out. Still spotted up all over his body under the skin. If it had not been for my brother who drove back from Houston, car flooded, garbage bags, over-soaked seats, I'm aching as I'm speaking. I am a mother of five kids. Many of my neighbors and children's friends died. So many would not have died. I'm just speaking out to let you know a portion of what happened. They told us, if you see the helicopters, you can flag them down. So many army trucks just was running past us. We even asked the police. They just looked at us as if we was nobody. He just watched us just vanish away and die. Okay. And this one is called Wedding. It's a news item some months ago. People who said they were guests said, dinner was just finished when the fighter jets, U.S. fighter jets, soared overhead. Jet roar jamming the tribal wedding music. The music just starting up. Out of nowhere, high beams from U.S. armored vehicles offering illumination cut by darkness. The party ended in apprehension. The men stayed inside the wedding tent. Women and children sheltered in a nearby house, witnesses said. Silence in the sky. The first shell hit the tent about 5 hours later, witnesses said. The deputy police chief of the provincial capital said the attack happened about 2:45 a.m. Panicked, women clutching their children ran out of the house, witnesses said. Women clutching their children searching the sky to see danger coming. Women in hasty cloaks, children wrapped in blankets, looking up at the night sky, since Guernica. The deputy police chief in Ramadi said, between 42 and 45 people were killed, including 15 children and 10 women. A doctor in a Ramadi hospital put the death toll at 45. 10 miles from the Syrian border, 80 miles from the nearest city, a wedding party? Don't be naive, said Major General James N. Mattis, a Marine spokesman in Fallujah. Plus, they had 30 males of military age with them. How many people go to the middle of the desert to have a wedding party? A shepherd who attended the wedding, Mahdi Nawaf, said his daughter and at least one of his grandchildren were killed. Where are the foreign fighters they claim were hiding there, asked Nawaf. Everything they said is a lie. Mothers died with their children in their arms. One of them was my daughter. I found her a few steps from the house. Her two-year-old son, Rod, was in her arm. Her one-year-old son, Ra'id, was lying nearby. His head was missing, the shepherd said. Oh.